Hello, everyone. Good afternoon, good evening, good morning. So today we are starting one more the Bridge Talks. The Bridge Talks is a series of informative lectures about the different fundamental concepts and the specialties of Conscienciology. It is organized by ISEC, which is the Interassistential Service of the Internationalization of Conscienciology. Today, the topic will be about Penta. Before we presenting our lecture today, our speaker, né, from today, we're gonna just display a little video, and after that, we come back presenting our speaker. All right, so who is the person who is giving the talk for us today? Flávio Amado, the date of birth, 23rd of November 1961. His nationality Brazilian. Hometown is Cachoeira do Sul, his state, in Rio Grande do Sul, in Brazil. He's graduated in agronomy, specialist in georeferencing. He studied a volunteer of Conscienciology since 1999. He's a professor of Conscienciology since 2002. He's Penta practitioner since 1997. He's a co-author and book organizer, Técnica da TENEPS 2017. And he's also coordinator of Penta, Conscientia-Centric International Organization, and the Invisible College of Pentology. So, without further ado, let's bring Flávio for a great talk this afternoon. Good afternoon, Flávio. I will
Good
leave with you.
afternoon. It's a pleasure to me to be here talking with you about the Penta, and my thanks to ISEC for the opportunity.
Excellent. So, let's start it.
Can Jacqueline put the slides for the start? When Jacqueline put the slides, I can start talking about my experience in the Penta practice. I started in Penta in 1997, and almost 24 years ago. And in my city, Cachoeira do Sul, Rio Grande do Sul, it's a little city in the country, and 200 kilometers from Porto Alegre. It's a big city of my state. Can you put the first slides? The first slide. It's very important and for Penta practitioner and even all conscientiologists, it's a principle of disbelief. Do not believe anything you read or hear in this presentation. Experiment. Have your own experience. We talk a lot about this during this talk, but it's a very important for the Penta practitioner, this principle of disbelief. Next. I think a lot of people know what the word Penta means, but we start with the definition. Penta is a personal energetic task. It's a daily transmission of consciential energy in a certain hour in the day and assisted by one or more helpers and in awake state. And directly to you or deficient, they are intangible and invisible to typical human vision. And I put the book Penta Manual. You have this book for download and in PDF. And I have old version of this book in English too. We have this book in English, in Spanish, and in Portuguese about Penta. It's very important to see this book. Next. Okay. Penta manual for download. And I think about the Penta history. Valdo Vieira say that empirical inexistive Penta without technique has existed since time immemorial. And I was thinking maybe we can make some sterilization of bioenergies in our past lives without technique. And but Penta was properly launched to the great public in 1966, according to entry on page 958 on the book 700 Experiments, Conscienciology Experiments. Today we have four books about Penta. And we have Penta Manual in English, and they have in Portuguese TENEPS, Interassistência Multidimensional Lúcida, Teáticas da TENEPS. How Ana Paula say, I am a co-author of this book, and Otimizações Pré-TENEPS da Katia Rakak. These books we have now about Penta. Next slide. It's important to say that Penta exists in order to substitute and eliminate the need for religion. Penta dispenses prayers, orations, mysticism, promises, and rituals of all types. All Penta practitioners depend on self-organization, self-sufficiency, perseverance, and confidence in the helpers. It's important in my case. And I work my with traits, strong traits, and I work in consensual therapy and consensiometry was a guinea pig, and I work in my religion way to manifestation. It's and in this book. Written by Marcelo da Luz, Where Does Religion End? It's a great book about religion and Penta is the place on the religion finish. It's, what the author say this, it's very interesting. And he puts a lot of our experience in this book. It's very interesting. It's heavy in Portuguese, printed, and in English, I think it's only for download, for demand. But I have two options. I have two languages for this, Portuguese and English. Next. People ask me about the place for Penta. Penta should always be performed in the same place. You choose a place in your home. The most common place is your bedroom. But the ideal if you have a space exclusively for practice. In my case, when I build my house, I make a room specifically for the Penta practice. We call this TENEPSARIUM, and it's ideal. But we know that a lot of people don't have conditions to have a specific place for Penta practice. Penta may be make in your bedroom. Living room should be avoided for the execution of Penta, because this place have a public atmosphere and lack of privacy. And bathroom, it's not an appropriate place. In my experience, sometimes if emergency condition, I make penta in bathroom one or two times, and it work, but it's not ideal. It's an exception. Okay, there are a verbete from Fátima Fernandes, efeito da mudança de tenepsário, and some talks from Valdo Vieira talking about penta place, your room for penta. Next. Objects. What are the objects we have in the penta room? And ideally, we don't use alarm clock in the penta place. We have a small clock, a digital clock, for you see the hour, but ideally you make your own biological clock work in order to wake you from the penta session at the exact time desired. Some students talk about your experience and that they wake in the exact time of penta finish. It's very interesting to do. If you have alarm clock, maybe if you are an ectoplasm, you maybe will have some effects of your ectoplasm origin. Don't not turn on electronic objects in the penta room. The ideal is turn off all electronics objects. In this photo, in this picture, we can see the penta laboratory in CIEC, and some objects like chair, white papers. It's very important to have white papers, pen, bedside lamp, small digital clock in the place. Maybe the helper, you need to note the inspirational reflections and original ideas you receive from during the penta exercise. Inspiration for the helper or extraphysical phenomena that you perceive. It's a very important that you make your registers. I sent to you, it's a show to you, it's my copybook to make notes. This is 24 and have 17 years, and my notations is here until now. And today in the Penta IC, we have a Penta diary, and to make notes, when I make notes, what I doing before Penta, how I feel, and during Penta practice and the after Penta practice. Other way to make your notes, maybe use an electronic device like this. Maybe you have a pen to make your notes. It's easy to lose some data because maybe you have problems with your cell phone or electronic device. The copybook is better in paper, but you need, after that, you need to enter this in your computer to make your balance of your annotations. Next. And every Penta organization, self-organization, is very important to the Penta practitioner. Every Penta practitioner depends on personal organization for the task. The following are some types of self-organization required among others. As somatic organizations, Penta depend for the healthy soma of the practitioner. I put a woman, make a walk, and it's very important, good conditions for your soma. Energosomatic organization, you don't It's very important you make your vibrational state routines during the day. You have more flexibility of your nervosoma, and it's very important. Affective sexual, you give and receive affect, and cosmoethical, Valdo talk about personal code of cosmoethic. It's very important for the penta practitioner. You have up to date your personal code of cosmoethic. And the chronological organization, like dates, like schedules, and it's very important. And the tosenic organization. It's a phrase from Waldo Vieira, says self-disorganization makes the healthy execution of penta impossible. We can think about this, the importance of the organization. Pilar Alegre is a volunteer for Penta IC, and she is a researcher about organization, Penta and organization. Next. Penta practice, it's very practical, because you make this in your home. And it's extremely practical with regard to woman life, human life. You don't have any problems with transit, traffic, and you do penta every day, including weekends. Every day you make penta, you don't have, it's more difficult to have accidents and problems before practice, because you are inside your own home. Next. Helpers. You don't make, do in penta practice, you are alone, intraphysically, but you have with you a helper. The helper, the penta practitioner has a helper dedicated that supervises and sustains the system task. It's imperative that the practitioner communicates with the helper. In the image, we put the penta practitioner sit in the chair. The helper sterilizes energies and for penta practitioner and the assistant in front of the penta practitioner. The wisdom of the helpers is shown in the just cosmoethical dosage applied in everything they do. In penta, the helper is the extraphysical co-practitioner. It's a very important difference between helper and blind guide. Blind guide, it's an anti-cosmoethical concierge that may be actually if a consim. And it's not a technician like a helper. And helper, if you don't have condition in some day to assist anyone, helper don't bring nobody for you. But if you have conditions to assist in one, they bring one, or two, they bring two. It's very important difference with the blind guide. Blind guide, you sometimes think you need to save the world, to save the planet, and respect the just cosmoethical dosage you are capable to support. And because this, when you have helper with you, a technician with your penta practice, you don't have problems after penta practice. You feel good, you feel better than when you start the practice. And they do have hangu, don't have the phasage of your energies. You feel better. Better, you feel good after the penta practice. It's very important, it's indicative for the helpers. The just cosmoethical dosage. Okay, next slide. When you start the penta practice, do maybe you have a connection if a big maximum mechanism. And Penta is based in a consensual link between the human mini pads and the multidimensional assistential maxi mechanism. It's a thing having its origin in extraphysical dimension. And before we born, maybe we make intermissive course, Penta practitioner, it's most problem to make intermissive course. And in this intermissive course, and you have a commitment to participate to Heuerbeck's extraphysical reurbanization. And it's a existential task in the planet, in the planet in this moment. And it involves a lot of persons. And I put in the picture about mini piece and of the maxi mechanisms. And other thing you can think about is about the millstone. The Penta practitioner in the position of interconsensual epicenter is the millstone of the mill, using the work of the extensional multidimensional energetic maxi mechanism. I understand better this condition when I make write the verbet about the ectoplast Penta practitioner. And the ectoplast have the more dense energies during our sterilizations. And this dense, it's very important. It's because this density, we call the Penta practitioner like a millstone of the mill. Next, time. What time do I do Penta? And we have a window of 3 hours period, and you choose inside this window 1 hour and to make Penta. Example, from 9 p.m. to midnight, it's a 3 hour window for you can choose for Penta practice. And you make Penta every day at exactly 10 o'clock, 10 p.m. And if you have some commitment, we can start Penta practice at 9 o'clock or start at 11 o'clock. You have 3 hours period, 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock. If you don't can start Penta practice until midnight in this window, the opportunity for assistance in this day pass. And you don't have feel guilt about this, it's no problem. In Penta manual, we have a provision about this. Some days you maybe don't make Penta. In next day, you start Penta normally. In the same time, 10 o'clock. Dialing saving time, in our country today, we don't have dialing saving time, but if you have, should be followed normally by the Penta practitioner. This time change is positive for the practitioner for reasons of temperature. Temperature below 20 degrees 10 degrees Celsius, it's good for ectoplasmic effects, and it's important. And when you travel, changes in time zone due to travel should also be followed. When I make Penta in other countries, like Argentina, Uruguay, United States, England, France, and I follow the same time, 10 o'clock. Everywhere I was, 10 o'clock, 10 p.m. It's my Penta time. It's fixed. When you have some difficulties in your life, because you have a new job or have to study at night, we can choose this time. it's don't need these times be forever. We can choose, and your helper, you can communicate your helper to choose, and even for the beginning of the day, it's 6 o'clock, and keep this new time for a long time if you can. Next. It's very important we think about the consensual hygiene. The practitioner must choose to see with all sincerity the better side of persons, concepts, environments, objects, ideas, institutions in order to help all involved. It's an important thing. A phrase of Waldo say, Penta demands that the practitioner does not think badly of anyone. When it's different when you exteriorize your energies alone and when you have a helper with you, it's potentialize your exteriorization. It's more strong, more intense. If you think badly about some person, maybe the helper don't potentialize these energies because you send a lot of energies, bad energies, for someone, and the helper don't can potentialize your energies in this moment. In this moment, the helper wait for a better moment to assist. It's very important for the penta practitioner, the consensual hygiene. Next. And in penta courses of penta IC, International Association of Pentology, some students make questions about teacher, talk about how are your penta practice step by step. And I put some optimization suggestions here and for penta practice. Preparation, 6 optimization suggestions just before practice, before you start the practice. Have a light meal 1 hour early. Avoid taking too much liquid. If you take too much liquid before practice, maybe you need to interrupt the practice to go to the bathroom. It's not the ideal condition. If you need to do this, okay, but it's not ideal. Take a shower, cleaning the skin. It helps in sympathetic de-assimilation. Then clear the skin. It's help you with the de-assimilation, same years. After that, you close the door, intraphysically alone, door and windows closed. It's very important. Some students talk to me, they use the door open. It's not good because when you close the door and the windows, you close the field, energetic field for the penta practice. It's very important to feel safe. Helpers don't bring an pathological consciousness if you don't have safe in security in your field, energetic field in your penta practice. And ideally, you lock the door. Lock the door. And inside this room, without animals and plants. Only you alone in the room. After that, you may can read some page about consensuality to calm the mind and avoid daydreams. My first article in consensuality is about daydream in penta. And I have some problems with my daydreams. And I usually to read some page of 700 experience, consensuality experience before penta practice to calm my mind and clear mind. Other thing you may do before Penta is make the basic mobilization of energies. It's like a warm-up. You mobilize your energies. It helps to install the field. And we make some circulation, vibrational state, sterilization, the absorption of bioenergies before practice. And the sixth suggestion is apply the technique of the accepts of daily contacts. We see this in the next slide. Next. What is daily contacts? The Penta practitioner's first step includes liberation of consensual energy of the most conscious, benign, tranquil, in favor of all those who they did not understand, did not treat well, or one day misunderstood in an antifraternal manner during the last 24 hours. And consists of recalling from your memory the images of the consciousness and conscience from all the day's interconsciential contacts, visualizing a shower of energy enveloping the consciousness with the sincere intention to place them in a state of grace in the best condition possible before your eyes. This provision of the acceptance of the emotions regarding one's daily contacts constitutes a cleansing of the dirtotosemic signatures left unresolved by the practitioner where they passed during the last hours. This technique, it's old techniques. I think this exists 1,000 years before other authors talking something like this. But it's very important. It may make your energies clean without angry, without bad energies. You think about people and sterilize your best energies. And when you start the Penta practice, you don't have your all problems in your vicinity. And you are open to receive other extension cases. Next, it's in the Penta manual, have this technique. And after that, we start the Penta technique. After these six suggestions, we start the Penta. When I do this, we read with attention the Penta request you receive in the last day. It's very important. This practice increases the rapport with the assistential case. Read one time is enough. I have some students that read, think, maybe I read every day the same Penta request. It's important. Maybe if you felt the necessity to read it again, maybe you do this, but it's not necessary. And but important to you read with all your attention. I remember that Professor Valdo say that they receive a lot of Penta requests, maybe 100 of Penta requests, and say, and he said that read this Penta request with all attention. It's very important. After that, you make yourself comfortable in your bed, preferably in the dark. The dark is important for ectoplasmic effects, and you may be comfortable in the chair too, if you have a habit to sleep during the Penta practice, maybe chair is better. But more common and a lion lied on bed, on the bed. Relax, calm your mind, and become psychically and physically passive to the extraphysical helper, who is a specialist in interconsciential assistance. will then be overcome by the phenomenon of benign or healthy interconsciential semi-possessions for the transmission of consciential energy. What is that? Next slide. Same sensations you have during the penta, especially during the semi-possessions. The following are some sensations: stiffness, torpor, lack of feeling, typical of same possession, parapsychic signal of the presence of the helper. It's very important. In my case, when I perceive the parapsychic sign in my ears of the presence of the helper, I know that penta will start. I'll be okay and penta will start in this moment. It's very important to you make the research of your parapsychic signs. It's very personal. Physical relaxation and great immobility, it's very common. Mental stillness and harmony with the helper. Perception of the energetic output flow, exteriorizing in conjunct with the helper. You can perceive, well, when you exteriorize alone, and it's different when you sterilize with the helper. Difficulty of the coupling between the mind of the extraphysical practitioner and the extraphysical helper responsible for the transmission. Maybe this because they dreams, if you have difficulty. You are thinking about something, it's not assistance. And maybe it makes this difficult to the coupling between the mind of the penta practitioner and the helper. Maybe you heard sounds of rhythms, vibrations heard inside the head during the energetic discards, and synchronics with the energetic spraying movements made with the arms and hands. Maybe you have movements of the arms and hands, maybe you don't. It's very personal, and if you have inspiration to move your arms, you can move. If you don't have, maybe you sterilize for all your body or for your trunk. Next. Maybe during penta practice, we will perceive changes in our vicinity. And maybe you perceive the chakras activity. It's very important for your parapsychic development. You can perceive the corona chakra, frontal chakra, laryngeal chakra activity. It's important. Maybe you have perception of the energies of the assistant. Maybe you feel some pain, some bad sensation. It is not your. It's of the sensations of the assisted. Between one assist and other, the semi-possession may become less intense. You feel like some free during this moment and change the assisted. Assistant may be causing cruise pace. It's like a travel, maybe. It's a cruise space. Near the end, it's very common with me, near the end, I've perceived the intensification of energies. It's indicated to me that the helpers are closing words. They make the syndeas, the assimilation of energies, and close words with an intensification of energies near of the end of the pentapraxia. E at the end, the perception that the process has ceased. It's a very important to talk about it. Do not think that the penta only works when there is a pattern of intense sterilization. The helpers have a technique for each assistential case. If you don't perceive anything, you pay attention in our sensations after penta practice. How do you feel after the penta practice? You feel good. It's a very important sensation. Next. have some questions from people of the internet or home. Ana Paula. Have some questions from people of the internet? Pleasure to see you, Ana Paula, but I think your internet is unstable, maybe a bit. When Ana Paula can return, we try to answer some questions. Other thing is important, the personal discipline of the practitioner demands that he avoid the practice of Penta when he started. It is always inconvenient in all respects. When it's happened, it's the best to invert the time of the task to the beginning of the day. In the morning, early morning, or after various periods of sleep, for example, and we have a hard day. We work a lot during the day, two periods or three periods. And when we start the Penta practice, you are very tired, and you just need to sleep. It's not ideal condition. And in this case, maybe it's better to invert the time of the task for the beginning for day. And start the day with Penta practice, it's a good start for day. Next. Ana Paula. No? Next slide. Many people have problem with sleep during the Penta practice because they are tired during the practice, don't sleep well. It's very important to be in the up of your energies during the Penta practice. Oi, Jacqueline. Your sound is turning out.
Until Anna comes in, I'm going to ask some questions to you, if that's okay to answer. And when Anna comes in, she can ask. She's here. Great. Flavio, you mentioned about effective sexual aspects. Can you comment about practicing Penta without being in a partnership? And this is from Ligia Decker.
Okay, Ligia, thanks for your question. It's a very important aspect for the Penta practitioner. If you have some type of lack or currency, maybe you can do this, and a lack of, you feel necessity of sexual, maybe you have a contact with energivores, conscience, that have the same question. And you, it's difficult to assist this consciousness. But if you don't have a lack of affective or sexual, maybe you don't have problems with this. Along of my experience, I had contacts with people that don't have partnership, and they don't have problems with lack of sexuality or deep sexual energies. They feel good and they make Penta practice without problems. But and people that have partners maybe have problem with this. It's an intraconsensual question like this. And but it's important to the Penta practitioner give and receive and affect and make active sexuality during your life. It's important. it's maybe facilitate to amplify your system capacity. And you do have many problems. You do have those problems with energy concepts, because energy, we call these concepts, because they are driven by sexual energies. It's very important aspect to work. But along of my experience, I have contact with people that don't suffer with this. It's more important, it's the condition of lack of currency of energies, sexual energies. It's more important. Okay, other questions?
Yes, there's another question here from Virginia Ruiz. How can we be more connected with our helper? And what are the suggestions to have more self-confidence?
Yeah, self-confidence is very important. After Penta Pratsi, we can stay for a moment during, after the Penta Pratsi, make your notes and think about your helper. And we think about the helper and have contact communication with this. If you think in the assistance, maybe you have contact even after the Penta Pratsi when you are asleep during the night. And the point of contact with the Penta practitioner and the helper is the assistant. And when you think in assistance, you have more connection if your helper.
Okay, so that's it for now.
And to have more self-confidence, think like a system. Don't think like you are assisted. Think you are assisted. When arrive a consciousness need to assistance to you, you think, arrive a consciousness that need assistance. I'm ready to assist them. It's you have more confidence in your practice when we take this attitude.
Okay, great. So we actually do have one more question. Ana Paula, she wrote a question here. Why should we do Penta?
It's a very intelligent thing to do in your life. It's, I think, in my case, I think it's a time before I start the Penta Pratsi and after start the Penta Pratsi. Penta organize everything in the life of the consciousness. And the most evolved form to make assistance is by bioenergies. And in this area, the most advanced technique is the plant, the Penta technique in this area. If you need to make assistance to help other people, Penta, it's indicate. And you be a better consciousness, not for you, but for assisted better, better assistance for others. You are need to qualify yourself to assist better.
Great. And another question is, what are some tips you could give to someone who is thinking of starting to do Penta?
Thank you, Abriel. We have today a lot of videos and talks about Penta. We have books about Penta. Read the Penta manual, make conscienceological courses about Penta, and ECP2 from IAPC. It's a very interesting course to do. Conscienciometric courses like ECP1, like IGNIEPIG, it's help you. But you will have a lot of information about Penta. And if you only you have the the power to decide if you can start or not the Penta practice. We read about a lot about this, have some a lot of information, and then you decide if you put the day you will start. For example, I'm starting 6 months ahead. You make your preparation. The book of Katia Arakaki, I have some example here. It's good for the Penta who is thinking about start Penta. You have a lot of tips. But you improve your vibrational states, mastering your bioenergies, and organize your life. If you have something to do before start the practice, like a golden travel or a marriage or have a son, it's better do you resolve this before you start the practice, and after that you start the practice.
Great, great. I'm not sure if you would like to continue presenting for a little bit more, because otherwise we have questions here. We have a few more questions, okay. But feel free.
Okay, we start some minutes late, then we start a little bit more.
Exactly.
Okay. The assimilation, it's a very important question. It's indicating if you have a helper with you, but some Penta practitioners have problems with this. The Penta practitioner need to be expert in the assimilation, same days. The practice of Penta does not produce energetic hangovers. You feel good after the Penta practice. Normally, you feel better than you start the practice. If you feel some problems, some lack of energy, some fatigue, some irritation, it's you will mobilize your energies until you feel good, because it's not common. And Penta does not produce energetic endorphins. Human beings need to research what they are going with the Penta practice. If you have some problem of bad sensation for practice. Next. Penta register. It's very important to make your registers. If you need to make registers to compare how are the development of your Penta. How are 6 months ago, how was today. It's very important. And you make yourself research. Next. And these registers you can present in the scientific events like Penta Forum. Penta Forum is an annual event that brings together practitioners, researchers, and interest in Penta, aiming at updating research, debating experience with cosmoethical, interstance, mental somatic, and claritesical purpose of new purpose. And in 2021, we have the Penta Forum and the Week of Pentalogy. This event is very important because we have today 90 verbetes about Penta and 130 articles in Consentia magazine. Pentology, it's specialty of Penta, and have more writings in this area. Other very important event, Jacqueline, is the International Week of Conscienceology. And we will have Penta Dialogues in 26 August in 2021. Debate Penta only in English. Can you talk for us a little more about the International Week of Conscienceology? Your sound is turned up.
Great, thank you, Flavio. So as you mentioned, we have this event, the International Week of Conscientiology, a 10-day event, which will happen from the 20th to the 29th of August, so in 6 weeks' time. And it's going to be a range of different activities related to conscientiology by different ICs, including the IC that Flavia is part of, IC2NEPS, and they're going to be giving a very nice activity, Pentadialogues, which you mentioned. So, yes, I guess if you want to know more information, then I think it would be very nice to participate. And the activity that you're doing is a free activity, right? So it's, but as a, you can participate in all the activities, the event, or choose, select those activities you want to participate in. But for more information, so there's for more information, you can visit our website, www.isaaccons.org. Okay.
Come participate with us of the International Week of Conscientiology. Okay.
Great.
Next slide. And it's important, the registers, the notes you make yourself, because Penta is different for the religion. Penta is a scientific and activity. Penta form. We have the Invisible College of Pentalogy, and I'm a coordinator. And we have meetings with researchers from all cities of Brazil and even abroad on the other countries. And we exchange change experience with the other researchers of pentology. Next. Penta CI and in 2016 and was founded the Penta International Association of Pentology, and with the specialty of this institution, consensus-centric institution, is pentology. It's we have courses, we have activities, Penta dialogues, diálogos tenepsológicos in Portuguese, and we have a lot of activities about Penta. We are welcome. Next. And if, for the last two slides, after initiate, the practice of Penta should not be interrupted for the rest of one's intraphysical life. And due to the initial intrusion, that the practitioner will be subject to being more intensive in the first 6 months. In my case, I started Penta 24 years ago and don't interrupt until now. And I think I will continue this activity when I have physical conditions to do this. It's very important. It's a commitment, a serious commitment. It's for Penta is for the rest of your life. Next. And the commitment being for the rest of one's life is the most serious and difficult aspect in the Penta practice. In this case, be aware and certain that it is undertaken is for the rest of your physical life, or at least until a heart attack, stroke, or some other incapacity, physical accident, permanently renders impossible the interconstitutional energetic existence. And I finish this presentation with this phrase from Waldo Vieira. Penta is the maximum experience of everything that is healthy for consciousness. If you think in assisted, in help other people, maybe you think about Penta. Thanks for the opportunity. Thanks for ISIC. It's a challenge for me. It's an interesting thing. I love Jacqueline. Yesterday in the Penta practice, I was thinking how I do talk about Penta in English. And the helper showed to me a little paper, the writing in the blue pen, in these words: think in your previous lives.
Yes.
I think it's a tip for me that maybe I have previous life in England or in the countries with native speakers in English.
But, exactly. Because it's within us,
for me.
Right? Yeah, it's the connection we make with ourselves, our previous.
When he showed me this, I feel more confidence about this book. It's
a fantastic
thing.
It is. It's very interesting. Mm-hmm. We have that ability within ourselves, right? Because of our experiences we've already had. So thank you very much, Flavio, for this presentation on Penta, which is such an important topic to talk about. And thank you very much. We look forward to you helping presenting the Penta Dialogues in August.
Yes, I hope to see you people in Penta Dialogues in August.
Great.
We can debate more about the Penta practice.
Exactly. And just, I guess, to talk about the upcoming bridge talks, I should just mention. So our next one is in September. So on the 11th of September, Gustavo Ferreira from Orthocognitivas will be talking about Cognopolis. So that will be in 2 months' time. Okay, so very nice.
Thanks for the opportunity.
Thank you. Okay. See you next time. Bye.
Bye.